I made a grave mistake. The kind that cannot be fixed.
Slowly, like the morning sun clambering over the horizon, consciousness came. He opened his eyes. How pleasant, he thought, to wake to nature's song. But something was not right. The song was out of tune. As he navigated the narrow paths, he breathed in the fresh mountain air. It focused his mind. Questions bobbed to the surface, like apples in water. How did I come to be here? He asked himself. No, that's not the right question. Nor is where I'm going. A single terrible realization crystallized in his fogged mind. I don't know who I am. Many stories have been told about poor souls who have forgotten the paths they have trodden. But there is more to this tale. That I promise. The soft glow of the man's lantern fell on an exotic bird, a hoopoe. The recognition hardened him. Perhaps the bird would lead to further revelations. He followed the hoopoe on instinct. Its beautiful trail fanned the flame of hope. He spotted something glinting among the rocks. Something that called to him. All he did was pull that hatchet out of the stone. A simple act with a remarkable outcome. the Revelations realm. There was no way back. Whatever this mysterious place was, he had to push on. The weight of the hatchets in his hands brought some comfort as he journeyed deeper.
Help me!
Who's there? The man called, his voice muffled by the thick, static air.
Please, help!
Where are you?
No answer came. He then felt despair, the kind that only the truly alone know. But he was mistaken. There was another in this ethereal place. The tree was alive, but bound tight by otherworldly rocks and glowing tentacles. The blades of the man's hatchets were sharp. The man didn't know if the creature were friend or foe. He felt its pain and fear. It mirrored his own. Was freeing the creature wise? The man did not know, but empathy overrode his rational misgivings.
What happened?
The man cried.
Where have you taken me?
Calm yourself, human. Did you not want to leave that alien realm?
The tree leaned closer and introduced himself as All Seeds, a pomegranate tree.
I don't know who I am,
the man said. All Seeds pondered.
Others, like me, have been afflicted by a sickness. Help them, and I will return the favor.
All Seeds told the man to look for talisman stones, strange rocks protruding from the ground. Destroying the talisman stones would free his kind. Then, the mighty tree extended a great branch outwards, pointing east.
Unearth the Kanat Gate to find the path forward, to find yourself.
The man could roll under low objects with ease. As he ran, the man mulled Allseed's words. How will rescuing the tree's kin help me recover my memory? He wondered. It appeared to be a diary entry, engraved into the stone. To whom it belonged was a mystery. As he trod the winding path, the man thought about everything that had befallen him. He worried about the nature of the sickness that Allseed had spoken of. How extensive was it? And how would it manifest itself? Little did he know that the answer to the latter question would begin to reveal. Itself a few steps further.
This must be one of Allseed's trees,
the man thought, breathing hard after his encounter. The tree had unfurled its vibrant leaves, embracing all but forgotten sunshine.
What were those nasty little creatures?
The man thought.
Are they tainted by this sickness, or harbingers of it?
as the second of all Seed's kin was released, night cast its veil over the land. The inevitability of dusk, the serene quiet of it, brought the man a sense of peace. Seeds was right. There is a sickness afflicting nature. The talisman stones must be at the heart of it. But where did they come from? Were those swarming creatures defending them? So many questions, so few answers. And still, he didn't know who he was. Farhad. My name is Farhad. But who was that pained woman? And why did she ask what she did?
Does she want amethystine stones?
Farhad wondered. Found himself in the Celestial Revelations realm once more. The desperate whisper echoed through the strange starscape, calling, beckoning. Farhad! Farhad! Farhad could hear years of agony in those few words.
Help me, Farhad, please.
Show yourself!
Farhad called into the twinkling black.
Where are you?
But if he was heard, the whisper didn't say. Wondered. One was of the mysterious woman in his hazy memory. She who pleaded with him to come to her. The other, no doubt, was Farhad himself. Was she the key to his past and his future? As the statue brought down its hatchet, the white liquid flowed. Farhad could only hope that soon his thirst for answers would be quenched. The din of the fallen bell shocked Farhad, but the dreadful roar of some unseen creature terrified him far more. Something sinister was watching, waiting. But Farhad seemed to have one ally. Although Alseed's motivations were shrouded in mystery, he had come once again. What do you know of that place? Farhad asked Allseeds. A shiver passed through the tree's branches.
It is the realm of lost memories and forgotten souls.
When I bit the pomegranate, Farhad said, I had a vision. I was engraving, sculpting. Is that what I do? Am I a sculptor? Allseeds pondered.
I cannot say, but memories can be hewn from stone. Consider that. More of my kind are trapped. If you can help them, perhaps I can provide answers.
Farhad turned to leave, but Allseeds held out a gnarled palm.
Be warned, though, human.
The great tree said,
a fearsome monster The Deev lurks in the Revelations realm. Pistoon is its name, after the mountain on which you now stand. Keep away from it if you wish to live long enough to uncover the truth.
Farhad stood back and admired the engraving.
Thank you.
Despite All Seed's warning, Farhad felt the seed of hope taking root in his breast. Although the path behind and before him was shrouded in darkness, now there was light enough to see his feet. All Seeds had proven that it could help Farhad regain his memories. And although he didn't yet have all the answers, he had purpose. And what is anyone without purpose? Thoughts never wandered far from the lady in his memories, but her face eluded his grasp. Has such deranged laughter ever heralded anything good? From its broken form. Felt a new affinity with his hatchets, as though they were a part of him. Night fell, as the last tree was cured of the blight. It was time to return to Allseeds.